just allows you to farm faster. Then you've got the 15 agi, which is a lot, but it's also versus the minus 2 second blink.
Yeah, you have to have the 2 second blink. Like, I remember we were having this long debate with Black over in China, and he's just like, there's no other choice right now. You can't keep your farming patterns unless you get that 2 second down.
Yeah, and that's the downside. It's like, now you have to choose stats versus your farm ability. And in the past, your talent tree lined up a lot more so that you could get both tanky and because of the 5 second blink cooldown. Like, this 1 second makes this hero feel really bad, Toby.
Yeah. That's what I'm actually really concerned. Like, after, like, throughout this entire major, we've seen they go, you know what, Aegis is a really great player because he understands these critical timings, avoiding small items in order to get the big items up and running, and then gets involved in the fights. And then you say to an anti-mage, you know what, Arteezy, you've been having a bit of a hard time, mainly because you've been pressured heavily, you're in a lane against Nipadden, good luck, bro. And now we're also going to make it harder to farm because the anti-mage blinks even slower. He can't transition through the camps any better.
Yeah, I think if Anti-Mage loses this game, and I said that the last time I saw an AM game, when there were zero stuns and zero counters to him, and he still lost, but I think this would be the one that makes me give up hope on this hero. I've already given up hope on Storm. Like, it doesn't even matter if the enemy team doesn't have stuns anymore, like, that hero still loses. But AM, I'll give it one more try.
So the new patch log's coming out, it's gonna be AM has 1 second less cooldown on his blink at all levels, and Storm Spirit gets some kind of indirect buff, and Omni Knight gets completely shredded. Yeah. That's what we're looking forward to learn from this major. Please, Ice Frog, make it so.
We're getting a mind control mid Abaddon.
It is. Metabuman actually went to the top, so yeah. I thought the mind control were going up against Arteezy, but they actually pair Venno against it. It looks like Matumba's still not exactly certain what he wants to level up. He hasn't skilled a single point. Waiting to see how this lane's going to pay off. Pan out. And words. Languages!
EG really is good. A little bit more traditional with how they run their course. Like, almost always.
Oh, universe.
The one and the two and the three. It's very
That's a lot of damage with Void, with the Chilling Touch bonus and the slow, plus the creep wave behind him. He'll salve up now. He brought consumables just for this. The salve will get cancelled.
He's fine.
Yeah.
But he's got 19 ghosts too.
Kuro's not wanting to give this
What
up.
Is this train?
Well, with the creep wave, they can dive under the towers at least and keep the pressure on him. You void again, you do some good range damage.
They're trying to deny the next wave over. They're trying to make it so that he can't just hold the wave in. And then the wave gets doubled. Yeah, but...
Well, Miracle's keeping this lane back pretty far. Like, it's in the perfect spot for the Morphling. He's 8-4 on the lane. Tide only got 2 hits out of this one. Matumba in trouble. Crushes there. GH wants to try and create space. Body block. Matumba! It won't happen. Fear's got the range damage.
Yeah,
they will find the first blood.
And this is just classic Liquid. Like, they're willing to sacrifice their one position like nobody else's. And I think this has always been a philosophy of Kuro's, is that what was really popular that we used to say is somebody's game has to be ruined so that other people can have a good game. Uh-huh. And this game, it just has to be Matumba Man. And I think out of all the carries, he's kind of embraced this role. You see Secret doing something similar with how they move around Ace. You know, sometimes Ace will play the true one, and other times he'll be this guy who has to just take every single fight so that mid one can prosper.
Yep. It's going to make it difficult when you're a team going up against this, right? Like, you come in with the mindset, we're going to focus on one hero, like the targeting of Samael with EG about a year ago. And everyone's like, let's just keep killing this guy, and then they switch him to the offlane. And things worked wonderfully then for EG. But how do you do that when you always have this lane switch? You're never certain who's actually going to be the one when both the three and the one can become the one.
Yeah, that's Liquid strength, is that all three players are willing to play whatever role is needed just to win the game. Whereas EG is still trying to figure out kind of the balance among that.
No Hunter in the night, he can't take to the trees, tries to void, use that movement speed with boots, and well, into the pit, won't be able to get there. Fear gets the second kill for Evil Geniuses.
Yeah, maybe not the hero that you want to get all these last hits on, but a kill is a kill. As Matumba Man, now level 3, GH did create a lot of space for him there. He was able to pick up quite a bit of farm off of this. And Anti-Mage and Morphling, identical in farm. As is mid, like, Mind Control is holding his own.
He's not doing too bad.
Yeah.
18-3 against the 15-4 Samael. Like, what do you even do? Like, you want a Shadow Strike? That's not gonna fly with Mind Control. So how do you even harass down the Abaddon? You can't kill him when you hit your 6, because Mind Control will hit his 6 by that point, and then Borrowed Time's just gonna cancel any kind of attack you have.
Yeah.
And Matumba Man's now being really efficient for the offlane. you talk about sacking him, but it's the power of the Venomancer when you've got these two camps easily close to each other. They have the Observe Ward up on the hill, so Evil Geniuses can't just throw down an aggressive ward and gank into the top lane anymore. Not without Liquid knowing what's coming.
Fear right now, spotting him out. Matumba Man doesn't have a TP or TZ. What he's trying to do right now is look at how many creeps are here. They're trying to completely zone him out so that he can't get any of this XP, because this would instantly shoot him to level 4.5.
Yeah.
That's why they're playing so aggressively. The point isn't to kill. The point is to just take him out of the zone.
Oh, if they can get the kill as well, they'll be happy with it. They force the Gale out, and here comes the TP from Kuro. Yep. So, no chilling touch cast just yet. And Matumba can now stand in lane. Kuro will leech a little bit of this experience, but at least having a level 2 Plague Ward is going to make it so Fear can't just 2-hit down the Plague Ward. And goodbye, Universe. Underneath the Tier 1 tower on the bottom lane, he dies. And now it's EG who will TP crit over. Someone has to soak up the experience. And space now gained from Matumbaman.
Both safe lane carries. Having a reasonably good time right now. The Morphling, though, with a heavy level advantage as a result of him being able to win this lane, largely dual lane. Whereas EG, they've been focusing a lot of their efforts on this tri lane. They assume that mid is going to go fine. It is for the most part. Mind Control is actually doing a very good job of keeping up. He's got a bottle with an ED in it.
It's practically even CS, so yeah. It's pretty good for him. And Crit now will die on the bottom lane. GH and Miracle working together once more to find these kills. And they're very happy to dive when you get a lot of one charges. There's 8 magic one charges on Morphling and 4 stick charges on that Nightstalker.
He hits for so much right now. It's 5 minutes into the game and he hits for 122. That's like how they're dying.
It's not like Universe has a lot to protect himself. Like, he's got one charges himself, but only 1 point up in Kraken Shell. And with Nightstalker being this aggressive, there's no stacks once again. We saw it in game 1. And game 2, it looks to be something very similar. Can't stack up anything. The Titan can't just anchor smash his way up through a couple of levels. And with Matumbaman reaching this level 5 shortly, level 3 Plague Wards will be difficult to deal with on top. They've already been committing 3 heroes to try and turn the balance of this top lane. Akuro run to the side. They're bringing GH over. The crush is nice, but then again, only hits GH. They keep running forward. Kuro wants to help out. There's the Chilling Touch bonus damage with the extra slow. Matumban's Plague Wards, a real nuisance for Evil Geniuses. Maybe they want to rotate. Samel's waiting on the shrine for somebody. But while all that happens,
again
lose Universe on this bot lane.
Yeah, this 130 damage a hit Morphling. Normally, you don't even focus on this lane because it's a one-on-one, but Miracle is just eating him up. He's got 3,700 net worth now. It's 1K above the next highest person, and it's only 7 minutes in. Can't understate how large of a lead that is for him. And he's even going to grab a tower on top of this first team.
Yep.
Maybe for the second game in a row, he's just going to get a relatively free game. Nobody can really touch him. It's not easy for them to gank him without Sumail rotating over, but Sumail's got his own problems to deal with in this mid lane. Mind Control holding him here, and so not a lot of support coming from the other lanes, and this quick start might be what Morphling needs to keep up with this anti-mage once he gets his Battle Fury.
Yep. And what do you even do as EG? Like, you went for the anti-mage, the panel was talking about it. What happens if any mage has a bad early game? Like, how does he even recover? Like, but what do you even do to rotate to the bottom lane? It's not like the anti-mage can go and stand against that Morphling, and the support that's there isn't enough to work either. The Wyvern and Salada, one of the most popular combinations teams were looking for in the first two, now really isn't that much of an answer because you don't have the level 6, you don't have the curse on the Wyvern, the control factor to then let the Salada get crushed, no implication, so you're not hitting this power point from the supports, while GH at the very end of the night time is still posturing to the EG supports.
Yeah.
That's where they can work it in. GH, trouble. Matumban hits the two-man Gale. He'll get up the hill. Matumban's not level 6 yet, so there's no Nova to intimidate them. But the slows, there's no answer.
Yeah, I think it's less the hero changes and more, that thought. Sumail coming in. He's got his ultimate too.
Yeah,
he doesn't want just Kuro though.
Yeah, he wants GH in the tree line and Kuro, but he won't get that. The scream comes in. GH will end up going down. Bottom lane, Universe dies once more. You can see Skriff frantically trying to move the camera around to catch it because he knew it was inevitable. TZ will blink away, but he can't stand here.
Yeah, he's hitting for way too much right now with the double damage rune. Constantly staying at 400 health. There's going to be no rebuttal as...
Do you just abandon the lane? Do you just let it go and push tight into the jungle?
Yeah, this is kind of insane. And I was saying, it's less about the anti-mage and the storm spirits of the world, and more that other heroes just push the pace too fast.
Ron, is I have enough damage to get through fear before the TP will complete? No. But this is now going to be a tier 1 tower on the top lane after EG have to abandon it. The Morphling on bottom, which, one, they can't kill, and two, they can't stop him from pushing.
I'm not sure what the answer is right now.
Yeah, I'm not certain either.
He's just... they can't really touch him. He's going to grab a tier 2. It seems like EG really have a rough time dealing with this style where it's
that's
or
working.
Protect one, or people are playing on one side of the map. Miracle just continues to play on the other. They're trying so hard to secure Arteezy's farm that they're not able to make moves around the map.
This is almost the worst here, but a good timing. 13 seconds till borrowed time comes up. Cooldown, Mind Control gets crushed up. Samael's got the burst damage available as he just let everything rip. For the moment, fear is coming down. So is Matum, and support to Mind Control sticks up. Where's that borrowed time? 2 seconds away. Couldn't get it up. And a Bannon Wall fall. So that's the second highest net worth on the field. But he's second highest net worth and behind by 2.3k to the Morphling.
Yep, and Miracle just continues to farm. He owns this bottom area right now. GH might go down. He's trying to get the
mail. He's got him. But then again, Fear here to help out Kuro. They're coming in one by one here, Team Liquid. Crit wants to go for more. No more TP supports on the way. Until now, underneath the Tier 2 tower, it's going to be Mind Control shielding up Kuro and then attacking into Fear. Where is that flight? It just isn't there for the Winter Wyvern. So EG continue to hunt for the kills, but with the protective shield bubbles of Mind Control, they just can't focus a target. Crit has to go into the sprint and run away. It'll wear off in a second, and then Mind Control will close the distance. Vortex up, and he actually pops the ultimate to keep the chase going. Who cares? It's a minute cooldown.
That was a cool play. I like that. He instantly pops it so that he breaks the stun so he can get the chase off. Crit might have thought that he was clear. Mind Control using the ults offensively, which is something we don't see very often at all. And now Miracle rotating to this mid lane. He's going to have something like a 13, 12 minute Lincolns. And this is what we're talking about. These heroes just push the pace of the game a little bit too quickly.
Yep.
There is still kind of a timer where EG, if they can hold out for long enough, Arteezy can carry them against these heroes.
Yeah.
But oftentimes teams, we saw it at Perfect World as well, they play so fast against the anti-mage, you never let them get online. Mm-hmm.
I just love, too, we're seeing just how dynamic Liquid can be from game one to game two. Like, yeah, you could have played a little bit slower. Yes, Miracle did get an amazing start, but they show the fact they don't just have to be this four-man ball. They can move around as five. It's not a one-trick pony, this Liquid lineup. They've got such depth to not only the roster, they can, like the heroes they can draw for every single role, but also the timing options they can attack you with.
Yeah, it's 12 minutes in. Miracle, 2,500 net worth higher.
At least Universe. Okay, so Universe has the ultimate available. Abaddon triggers off the borrowed time. That's what the curse was onto. Now you go for your crush. Crit just gets popped by Miracle. They want to go for more, but shields and one charge is Mind Control. He'll shrug it off. Universe, you can ulti this if
damage.
You want to, but you're not going to achieve anything. The rest of EG bailed out. You have Sonic Wave. You have Rabbit.
Miracle.
And they couldn't do anything. Miracle.
He's Arctic
is going to go for more. He's going to kill off Wyvern. We're caught a fly. Morphling.
He uses the morph so he can slow down for the hit. They just run at them right now, and EG, they can't play the same kind of style. They've got a hero that effectively can't really fight with them right now, and Liquid know this.
Oh god, Lincolns is under 13 minutes, it gets completed.
Yeah, they've played this kind of defensive hero style too, where they've got this hero like Abaddon and Venno, both heroes very hard to kill, and so EG feel like they have no moves to make. At the same time, they're trying to create space for this anti-mage so they don't just lose all their tier 2 towers. But Liquid is playing at a blistering pace right now, not allowing EG to get any sort of
foothold in this game. Oh, Arteezy, car. Give him a break. He'll blink himself out. Actually, thought for a moment. Oh, it's because he didn't have mana, GH. He jumped over, but using Hunter of the Night and Voidman, he didn't have Crippling Fear.
Now they're going to grab this last tier 2 tower of the game. At 13 minutes, Liquid have all the tier 2s.
A kill for EG! A kill for EG!
Everyone TPs out, goes back to their base, and now EG in a situation where it looks like they just have to hold high ground now at 13 minutes in. This Morphling has 2,000 gold on top of his Lincolns. We talked about how he just got his Lincolns 2 minutes ago. 2 minutes later, he's got 2,000 gold in the bank, nearly double the farm of the next hero, even on his team. Like, this is pretty one-sided right now. 10,000 uh-huh. gold lead at 14 minutes.
Yeah, it's a very hard ask for EG to hold, but we'll hold on to the faith as Ice Blast will hit a range creep. So at least a little bit of a waste. Miracle. Samael doesn't want anything to do with that. No adaptive strike. If this E-Blade's online, Samael is dead the second that jump happens from Miracle.
Yeah, they're trying to force him back. He only has 700 HP loaded up, but he's just going to TP top. And EG, they're doing whatever they can. They understand that this anti-mage hero, if you allow him time, he can do it. But yeah, they don't have a lot of time right now.
He's so close to the Battle Fury. Like, he can buy it now if the courier can safely get into the side shop, into the secret shop, but that's a pretty tall order as well. He's just blinking back. Courier is now making the run out. So Battle Fury timing is not horrendous.
No,
it's going to be 15 minutes up for the anti-mage. Can they create the space? Where does the vision game start getting played?
Considering they don't have any towers, it's not bad at all. It's just when you look over at the other network and you see that Miracle is 5,000 gold ahead, which is a full major item. Yeah.
We'll cross that bridge when it gets blasted up. For now, get him space, get the Battle Fury up and running, and let Arteezy slip outside of the base and start farming. Like, just, can he even just go Radiant side? Team Liquid own the Dire side. They're spending most of their time there. Samael pushes out the bottom. They can bring down that tier 1 tower with a catapult wave. Maybe they have some space for Arteezy.
He's got to cut waves right now. Like, he can't allow Liquid to just go for the high ground. Liquid, a very disciplined team. As that bottom, mind control. He gets Winner's Curse. I don't think he really cares about this, though.
Yeah, especially after Samael already TP'd all the way back.
That's a little bit of miscommunication.
They're not keeping the pressure up. Now Winter's Curse will be down for 70 seconds. Arteezy is still getting more space up on the top, pushing it quickly. But he's so concerned. As far as Dire Vision goes, they do have one ward watching Kuro and GH. It's just, well, right next to Arteezy. Moving like it's not even there.
He's gonna get pinged out, but
Samael's back to pushing bottom lane.
Yeah, they have to split the map right now.
But he doesn't have a TP scroll. Like, if Liquid want to go high ground, Samael's cooldown is still 40 seconds on that TP.
I look at Matumba Man, by the way. He's farming the area that makes Dire side Venno so good. And he's just like, this is mine. I guess I'm Dire Venno.
Palm for Arteezy. He's taking Plague Ward after Plague Ward.
Doesn't take it very quickly, where's
the micro, Matumba? Deny those Plague Wards. Not happening. Efficiency, please. Universe is getting some space up on top. Gonna try and build into a pipe. Impossible to save his team.
Possible. He's got the cloak aspect of it.
Slowly, at least he'll have the hood. But he's thinking about his mana issues too. He's trying to build arcane boost for the squad. Very simple attack into Roshan. This lineup, 10 times better at killing off Roshan.
Yes. Well, when your Morphling is this farm. Mm-hmm. He's got an E-Blade now. 4 minutes after he picks up his Lincoln.
Alright. Here's the space creation. This is what EG needed to have happen. Tier 1 towers lost on bottom. They need to be on defense. Ultimates need to be used this time around. Titan to Ravage, Sonic Wave. Get the Curse in the right position. Even let Curse set up the fight. The problem they're probably going to have, however, is Miracle's the only one on the front lines. Nope, Mind Control will join him. So they got two to choose from. A Tier 3 tower, that's Fortification to save it. Samael is still creep skipping out. He'll start his TP back now. Needs a little bit of time to build up the mana. Fortification bought a little bit of that time, but the Tier 3 tower is gone. Universe can't close the distance, but that's what the curse is for. Abaddon, the ulti comes out. They're not moving in. The curse is used, but there is no follow-up. Once more from EG, a rinse and repeat of the battle on the Tier 2 tower top. And there's your E-Blade popped, not enough damage. The Crush from Crypt bought some space, but here comes your Ice Blast. Fear, get out of your own hug!
He wants Universe 2. He's going to keep going for this. Dive into their base. Doesn't matter.
Oh, boy.
18 minutes in. They've got a full set of racks. 14k ahead.
Run, crit! Run!
Nope, he's going to go down too. Liquid is relentless right now.
Arteezy creep skipping, doing his job.
Yeah, they're not going to make the mistakes that Na'Vi did. This is a very disciplined push.
Yeah, take the mid lane. Then prep to go wherever else you want to pop. Like, you've got the Aegis Immortal still on Miracle. And this rate, he's going to complete up Skadi before they even push the next high ground.
the pace of this game right now. It's just anti-mage can't really keep up. He usually needs this timing window of 30 minutes. Once he gets to like 30 minutes, then he's going to be fine against this lineup, but it's not even the AM's issue, right? It's the rest of his team right now is just getting crushed. He's 1-0-1. And nowadays, it feels like the strategy about playing against an AM is
curse.
Farm doesn't really matter.
2 seconds. 1 second. Fear. Oh, down he goes. Arteezy cleaning up the creep wave. Mind Control stands at the front lines as the Plague Wards are putting down Miracle. Wondering who he really wants to pop. He doesn't have the combination for another 8 seconds, but then the damage into crit is unbelievably high. Waveform in. The Ravage wants to buy more time.
Yeah,
and the
Leaf
throws the IA ult all the way into base, but it connects on Samael hiding in the fountain. E-Blade pop once more. This game is done. It's over. Not even 20 minutes on the board. It's an ultra kill.
He's pinging
for Miracle.
The
he wants it. Give it to him. Arteezy in the corner. It's a Rampage for Miracle! And a grand final for Team Liquid while they'll face up in a revenge match against Team Secret.